Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? Well, I'm going to begin with a view of a particular object that, as you can see in the little green window here, all the way around the screen, is a pretty nice star cluster. If you came across this in most any situation throughout the sky, you'd probably look at it and say, hey, that's a pretty nice star cluster. There's a good 8 or so stars that are eighth magnitude or brighter in this little patch of sky. There's a bunch of other ones that are dim that would be visible under darker skies with larger telescopes, and there's even some other ones over here. That's a great object. Where do I find that? Well, you're almost always near it in the winter because most people look for an object that's right next to this one and they overlook this one. So where exactly are we looking? Well, this is NGC 1981, which happens to be in Orion, right near the Orion Nebula. Look, Orion Nebula would be right here. I actually turned it off using the camera function, or this nebula function, to turn the camera on and off of the Orion Nebula. Most people aim at the middle section of the sword stars because that's where the awesome nebula is, which is, of course, a great object to look at. But don't just look at that. There's other things to see in Orion. So when you zoom in more, you can see there's this nice open star cluster right there, NGC 1981. It's about 1300, 1400 light years away. It's part of the Orion OB Association of Stars. There's lots of bright, hot, young stars right in this area, and they form a neat little cluster that you can see. That's not the only thing that you may be overlooking when you look at Messier 42 and miss all the other great stuff in the area. Don't just look at NGC 1981, although that's of course a great object. Look below where the actual nebula is itself, and we've got a couple of double stars too, in particular Iota Orionis, and that's right here where it says Hatzia. And this is a double star that is fairly close together. But what I actually like better is one that's nearby, which is Struve 747. These two stars right here, these are actually both very bright stars as in terms of their spectral type, because they're very hot white stars. But there's also a companion that's nearby that looks kind of reddish. So between the white and bluish look of the two primary ones, there's a tertiary one that's very dim, though. Yeah, it's about 11th magnitude, so you're going to be looking for something very faint. So even if you just see these two stars, you've got a couple of great objects to be able to see in Orion, not far from the Orion Nebula. Just look above it for NGC 1981 and below it for Iota Orionis and Struve 747. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies. And don't forget to like me on Facebook, follow me on Twitter, or even on my Instagram account. I'm going to have a lot more content coming up over the next year, and I hope that you'll share those things and also help other people find things in the night sky to see the wonderful objects around us in our universe. Thanks.